Challenge, I've been catching up with you, sparring with Mark Leach. He's not actually got a fight, but you have.
Yep, I'm fighting on the 26th of September against Carl Williams. Really looking forward to it. At my new weight, up at Bantamweight. So, yeah, really looking forward to it. It's a great spar, nice to move around with Mark. And, yeah, he's an awkward little tricky southpaw.
He is, he's got a bag of tricks, isn't he?
Yeah, but that's what we want. We want someone like that. We know Carl Williams is a bit switcher himself, so I believe Mark's a better fighter than Carl. No disrespect to Carl, but yeah, so coming and getting a better version of Carl is what we need.
Do you feel we're getting a better version of you? How you've moved up in weight, mate?
Yeah, 100%. At flyweight, I felt very frail, especially inside range. When I was throwing my punches, my legs weren't underneath me because I went strong from the solid foundation up to the core, so I'm looking forward to my bantamweight debut, if you like. So it's a new weight. It's I'm moving up 6 pounds. So yeah, I do really think that it's going to become. You'll see the best of me.
But I was all surprised because when I used to see you and your kid together, your kid was fighting at the heavyweight. You were fighting at the lightweight. I think he was super fly. Yeah. You were fly.
Yeah.
And twice the size of him, so I think it was crazy. This seems obvious.
Yeah,
that you should have moved up and maybe even a bit sooner.
Yeah, most definitely. Like a lot of people don't remember that I was a super flyweight before I moved down for the world title shot against Rosales. So moving down from super flyweight, where I was at for 2 years, having moved up from flyweight when I boxed Casemiro in 2016, I grew into the super flyweight division, and then the opportunity came up and I took it. But that was always going to have a like time span on how long I could make it safely, especially going from camp to camp to camp. It just took its toll on my body. And then what happened in my last fight was probably a blessing in disguise, because I've moved up to super flyweight and took my world ranking with me. I'm ranked at number two in WBC at super flyweight, and I will be campaigning at super flyweight when all this corona kind of goes away and I can fight for the world titles again. That'll mark me at super flyweight at world level. But at the moment, why this is all on, why not bantamweight? And who knows, I might find this is my perfect weight and I might stay here.
But well, it's like I say, you don't look out of place.
No.
You know what I mean? Mark's a bantamweight, he's a big bantamweight. He's small. You don't look out of place there. So for me, like I say, it was always bizarre when you see stood next to your brother.
Yeah.
How big you were compared to him.
It's definitely like when I was down at flyweight, it was like half of me. Like I dropped 5 kilos the night before the weigh-in. And that's 10% of my whole body weight. I'm weighing 50.8 at the time, so I was 55.8, and I had to drop that the day before a weigh-in. That takes its toll. You try and fluid up, hydrate back up, but sometimes it backfires. Mm-hmm. And my last fight, it backfired, and I didn't hydrate up as good, and I was piss poor, really.
There's an art to refuel, isn't there?
Yeah.
You know, making weight is...
Definitely.
I mean, I believe that all day before, when you're day before weigh-ins, you should start from the beginning of your career.
Yeah.
I know it's not financially right for everyone, but for me, it's a lesson that needs to be learned earlier rather than later.
Yeah.
Because if you don't get it right,
it's health. Your health's at risk every time you step in that ring, and when you're doing that severe percentages of weight cuts, it can fuck you forever. It can change your fighter forever. So it was just a no-brainer to move up. My coach, Grant Smith, my team at MTK Global, myself, we went to specialists and got all the tests done. And they said, what are you doing? You could kill yourself. Do you know what I mean? So
yeah.
It was time. It was time to move up.
Mm. And like you say, we all say it's 3 pounds, you know, between the weight divisions and the lower. But 3 pounds is a lot of weight.
A lot.
It is, yeah. You know.
Especially if it's water weight.
Well,
fat, you can take 3 pounds of fat off, but when you're dropping that water weight, at, which brings all the water out of your brain,
which is a protection, isn't it?
Yeah, that is your protection. So when you're doing that much weight in water, it is a dangerous game.
Well, someone was explaining it to me. He said, imagine getting 6 chicken breasts. Because a chicken breast is about half a pound.
Yeah.
So you strap a couple underneath your chest, a couple on your either arm.
Yeah.
and you've got to lose that weight.
I know.
So that's where, you know what I mean? You imagine strapping at home thinking, that's how much I've got to lose.
And I think many fighters stay at weights too long. And that's just because in your head, you're used to doing that all the time, and you think, oh, he's doing
it. Well, that's what we were speaking about before, wasn't it?
A lot of fighters who do change and move up and grow into a next weight will actually probably perform better at that weight. But that's what I'm going to do anyway.
I was going to say, so that's what we expect to see you.
Yeah.
And what's it going to be? 10 round, you said, over Cameron?
10 round fight. I'm not sure if they've got a title for it. They were trying to get a title for it. If not, it is what it is. For me, I'm looking forward to getting back in the ring. I've been out a year. 31st of August last year with my last fight, so I've worked a lot on myself, my body, my conditioning, my mental strength. So coming back, it's going to be good. It's going to be good to put the past in the past and start a new journey.
Right. Well, so I'm looking forward to watching you get back onto the winning ways, and like I say, good luck for whatever comes your way.
Nice one. Thanks a lot.
See you later, Charlie.
For all boxing info, news, and latest interviews, amateur and pro, across the north, click and subscribe. VIP Boxing Promotions. Also, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.